Okay, imagine with our reference to our previous class, in which we were taught introduction to soil microbiology. Microorganisms which are present in soil, they are responsible to maintain the life, to maintain the uniformity of this globe, and to make it suitable for every living organism. We have talked about this in our previous class. So today we have to talk about primary and secondary minerals of soil. If you remember yesterday, we have talked that parent material of soil, that was rocks, and the rocks has been converted into soil through weathering. And in weather, especially we talked rain, temperature, time, and activities, global activities. So today we are going the primary and the secondary minerals which are present in soil. We will talk about it. Primary minerals. Minerals that have persisted with little change. Minerals that have persisted with little change in composition since they were extruded, E-X-T-R-U-D-E-D, extruded in molten lava, एग्जाम्पल में लिख लीजिएगा आप क्वार्टर्स, QURTZ, क्वार्टर्स, मीका, MICA, एंड फील्ड स्पार, एंड फील्ड स्पार, they are most prominent in sand and silt fraction. These are most prominent in sand and silt fraction. So this is the first statement which we are generating about the primary minerals. So about primary minerals, which is the basic unit of this soil, primary minerals, the scientists, they are saying that they are present as it is with few exceptional changes. Parent material jitna bhi hai soil ka, वो एज इट इज मौजूद है, सिर्फ थोड़ी कुछ तब्दीलियों के साथ. तो उन्होंने एग्जाम्पल कहाँ से ले लिए, जो मोल्टन लावा निकलता है रॉक्स से, वो उसका जब कंपैरिजन किया, वो सैंड, वो सॉइल जिसके अंदर सिल्ट और सैंड मौजूद है, दे हैव ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर फीचर, लिटिल बिट चेंज बिकॉज वी आर कंसीडरिंग द मटेरियल विच इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड ऑफ दिस प्लैनेट. And the axis of the human is very difficult to go over there. But lava, which is coming from depth of this planet, depth of this globe, carrying the basic material of this globe outside. If we will compare that, because outer side of this globe, if you are looking at here, this globe, okay, the outer side, if you were studying, have soil, and how soil has been formed? Weathering through time. Through time. So this is converted into soil. But when lava is coming from, you don't.
Either it is coming from here, either it is coming from here.
So lava represents the original and basic material of this planet, parent material of this soil. So the chemistry composition. Composition of lava plus N, sorry, no plus N, soil are almost similar, but with few exceptions, with few changes. Thodi si tabdiliyon ke saath parent material as it is maujood. So there was a universal statement about this planet that everything which is present on this globe, it is the basic acid and the basic sarmaya of this globe. Basic acid of this globe. Nothing can go out from this globe. And nothing can come from outside to this globe. Everything which is present in this globe is the basic acid of this planet, soil. But it changes, it shapes. Okay, these are the primary minerals. Primary minerals are similar to the soil main fractions. Primary minerals are similar to the statement humne diya. Primary minerals that have persisted with a little change in compositions since they were extruded in molten lava, quartz, mica and feldspar. They are most prominent in sand and silt fractions. Sand or silt fraction mein wo is it is numaya hai, yani composition similar to lava ke andar hai wahi soil ki surface ke upar bhi. Secondary minerals aap kaun se hai? Primary minerals mein aapke paas quartz hai, sand hai, silt hai. Secondary minerals mein minerals such as the silicate, secondary minerals, minerals such as silicate, clays, C-L-A-Y-S, clays, and iron oxide have been formed by the breakdown and weathering of less resistant minerals as soil formation progressed, So read this statement twice silently. खामोशी से इस सेकंड स्टेटमेंट को सेकेंडरी मिनरल्स के मुतालिक आप खामोशी से पढ़ें दो बार या तीन बार. ये क्या कहना चाह रहा है? सेकेंडरी मिनरल्स, मिनरल्स सच एज द सिलिकेट, क्ले एंड आयरन ऑक्साइड हैव बीन फॉर्म्ड. दीज आर नॉट नेचुरली एक्जिस्टिंग. दीज हैव बीन फॉर्म्ड बाय द ब्रेकडाउन एंड weathering, by the breakdown in weathering of less resistant minerals as soil formation progress. So what we want to see, suppose this is below, these are mountains, through rain, here, in rain, what happened? From surface, if some particle, small and minute particles, they are removing. वक्त के साथ साथ जो भी रॉक्स हैं उसकी सरफेस वेदरिंग के थ्रू रिमूव हो रहे हैं. व्हाट हैपन, नीचे से नई चीज एक्सपोज हो रही. अब मेटल्स या एलिमेंट जितने भी, हाउ मच मेटल्स एंड एलिमेंट्स हैज बीन डिस्कवर्ड टिल दैट दे हैव एबिलिटी टू रिएक्ट विद एनवायरनमेंट. दे हैव टू रिएक्ट विद एनवायरनमेंट. सपोज आयरन, आयरन कैन नॉट लिव एज इट इज. When oxygen will be available, it will react with oxygen and will form oxide. Hydrogen cannot live as it is. When it will form, it will react with oxygen, H2O. Similarly, every rock is made up of some element. Some element. When it is superficial surface, reacts with environment, it is nature change. You are getting this point. Suppose loha hai, lohe ke upar jab zang lag jata hai, uski structure change ho jata hai. And gradually that removes. Aur niche se dusra loha expose hoga. Again that will react with oxygen. Kuch waqt ke baad wo bhi remove hoga. Dusra loha original jo basement mein wo expose hoga. That will react. Gradually it will convert into soil. The same thing is that, so these iron oxides, these are secondary minerals, and this has been formed due to environmental weathering and due to environmental reaction. But in nature it is clear that reactions are going very, very, very slow. Suppose diamond is forming from carbon. If you will put carbon inside of the soil for 1,000 years, it will form diamond. But reaction is very slow. Because I cannot live for 1,000 years to see my diamond to break down. Everything, secondary minerals are result of reactants, result of reaction. So, ab dobara is kahani ke baad, secondary minerals such as the silicates, clays, and iron oxides have been formed by the breakdown and weathering of less resistant minerals as soil formation progresses. These are the primary and secondary minerals. लेकिन अगली है वेदरिंग ऑफ रॉक्स. वेदरिंग ऑफ रॉक्स, इट इज फिजिकल एंड केमिकल. इट इज फिजिकल एंड केमिकल डिसइंटीग्रेशन एंड डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ रॉक्स. इट इज physical and chemical disintegration, disintegration, disintegration and decomposition of rocks. Weathering of rocks means it is physical and chemical disintegration and decomposition of rocks. Weathering creates the parent material over which the soil formation takes place. Weathering creates the parent material over which the soil formation takes place. Later weathering, soil formation, later weathering, soil formation and development, soil formation and development proceeds simultaneously. Later weathering, soil formation and development proceeds simultaneously. अब यहाँ पर एक बात मजीद की आप लोग यहाँ पर देखें. We should accept it as a scientific background or if we have a scientific concept. The rock, the parent material, is not has been directly produced. It has been formed due to chemical reactions. Chemical reactions. Rocks has been formed and developed due to chemical reaction, and these rocks then providing a basic material for the soil formation. So soil genesis has taken so many, many years. We have no calculator and we have no time-back vehicle that we will count it. First chemical reaction has been started that has formed parent material of chemical reactions have taken for millions of trillions. I don't know how much time has taken to form certain rocks, and then weathering started on that rocks and they started to form soil. And first life expectancy, which you can say that microorganisms which were able to take their energy from rocks in presence of sunlight as a scientific concept. Microorganisms developed which were able to take their energy from rocks in presence of sunlight, chemoautotrophic bacteria. And from that organic material has been started on the surface of this planet. So if you will calculate due to this slow reaction, chemical reactions, weathering, and then any biological development of any biological molecule that was that developed and adopted in that environment to take energy from environment, from soil, from rocks in presence of sunlight, developed a huge organic material content on surface which supported to the current scenario and current life status of this globe. So this is very long trouble. Physical weathering. What is the physical weathering? दो चीजें हमने उसमें काउंट की, कौन कौन सी? फिजिकल एंड केमिकल वेदरिंग. फिजिकल में हम देखेंगे कि क्या क्या चीजें इसमें आ जाते हैं. नंबर वन इज टेम्परेचर प्लेड अ वाइटल रोल इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस ग्लोब. Because some assumptions are saying when globe was formed, it was hot, red hot. Maybe during that time chemical reactions have taken place. Or due to chemical reactions, maybe the temperature of this planet was so high. And maybe either they are saying directly, indirectly, or with any proof, the soil had formed, it was red hot. The temperature was so high. And gradually it has been cooling down. Maybe that there was a disaster in any planet and some friction come towards this region and hanged into this atmosphere. We don't know. Bahar. All our assumptions. Physical weathering. Temperature played a vital role in formation of this soil. Zameen ke banne mein darj hararat ka sabse bada kaar. वो कैसा डाले कैसे हाउ टेम्परेचर कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन सॉइल फॉर्मेशन बिकॉज डे टाइम टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज एंड नाइट टाइम टेम्परेचर रिड्यूस एंड डिफरेंट मेटल्स एंड एलिमेंट behaving differently in different temperatures. When temperature raises, the density of some element reduces. You are getting my point. When temperature increases, density of some element reduces. What happens? It is volume and size expands. When temperature reduces, they are going to be, again their density is going to be increased and they will be compact. So that time they are going to break. They are getting cracks. And they are getting space when temperature increases, density difference is there. Suppose this is one drop, it is another drop. Temperature is working over here. It has been expanded and at reduction time, air will enter into this second drop, second layer of that drop. So what will oxygen will be acting here and it will create a space between this and this. So gradually, when there will be wind, when there will be rain, the outer side, the upper side will be removed. And this phenomenon is called exfoliation of rock. टेम्परेचर के बढ़ने की वजह से उसके ऊपर एक पटपटी थोड़ी सी चीज उखड़ गई और उसकी वजह से एयर और टेम्परेचर और मॉइस्चर के वहां जाने के दाखिले में उसका एक्सेस हो गया और ऊपर वाली लेयर फिर टूट करके दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एक्सफोलिएशन टेम्परेचर. Second thing which played a vital role, physical factor. We are talking about physical factor. Second is what? Temperature. Dusra environmental factor kya nazar aa raha hai? Which maybe have contributed in formation of soil. Wind. No. Usse pehle ek cheez what? What? Rain. Barish was when two type of reactions is doing due to water. When water is coming in a rock, suppose if this is a phosphorus rock, what will it will take phosphorus with itself that will form sulfuric acid. When concentrated sulfur rock is there, it will mix with water, it will form H2SO4 sulfuric acid, which is very strong acid, and when it will react, it will react with other rocks, suppose tuna, calcium carbonate, and other rocks that will break into what? One, water contributed in chemical reaction. Second, during rain, it exfoliated. It removes the small particles from every rock. It removes every particle from every rock. Or third, how it contributed? Number one, it contributed in chemical reaction. Number one, contributed in chemical reaction. Number two, physically removed superficial particles from rock, surface particles from rock.
first particle. और सेकेंड थिंग
और क्या कहते हैं जो कट होते हैं किसी बाहर के दरमियान जो दरार होते हैं क्रेक्स वाटर वेंटिंग इन टू क्रेक्स इन ओपन इट मोर इन मोर एक्सटेंड इट क्रेक्स downsides. It contributed the soil formation. These physical factors helped in the soil formation. Secondly, wind.
This is your change. Is that your factor?
Wind also contributed similar. Wind contained oxygen that carried oxygen into the inner and available surfaces of the rocks. You are getting this point. Hawa chali or rocks jo recently kisi bhi wajah se open ho gayi hai ya us pe koi surface expose ho gayi hai us tak oxygen ko pahunchaya. और इसमें ये एबिलिटी है कि वो माइनर स्मॉल से स्मॉल जोन और पोर से भी क्रॉस कर सकती है वहां पहुंचकर ऑक्सीजन की सप्लाई की उसने उसके साथ रिएक्टिव करके कोई सेकेंडरी मिनरल बनाती है. वन
oxidation providing oxidation chances to new newly exposed parent materials and newly exposed parent rocks. पहला फंक्शन ये क्या सेकेंड फोर्सेबली रिमूव द सुपरफिशियल पार्टिकल्स विंड फोर्स विंड फोर्स रिमूव सरफेस पार्टिकल्स particles of rocks that Wind force removes surface particles of rocks in relocation of sent and received particles. Location of sent and sent particles.
These things are contributing soil formation. Because if you will see in desert areas, the sand, if it is presented today here, maybe next day it will be at another site. If you have traveled Middle East or in desert areas, the sand mountain one day will be here, another day it will be in another place. That is relocating, and that is due to wind. And during this transfer, that is going to be degrade and convert into a small particle. Fourth and last, plant and animals. These are playing vital role in soil formation, plant and animal. How plants are contributing in soil formation, if you will see. In that, when plant roots, they are going into the soil, if there is cracks are available, plant roots are going to those cracks and is building it more. They are increasing the cracks. What will be? When plant root went into the crack that has been extended, where water will go, oxygen will go, and the weathering will start rapidly, and that crop gradually will be converted into soil. Same time, it is contributing organic material to the soil, which will mix with small particles of sand and silt and will form black soil, which is called mold, and which is basic asset of this planet, supporting to the living organism. Similarly, plant roots, they are excreting different chemicals. Those are also reacting on parent material in acidic form, in alkaline form, and they are reacting with parent material, which are also converting the status of parent material and breaking down it into soil and small particles. Animals, when they are going for grazing, due to their feet, they are breaking down the rocks into small particles. When they are going to the rocks, their feet, they will remove a small particle. And when there will be a rain, that will be further removed and exposing parent material to environment, to weathering, and superficial layer is going to be converted into soil. So these are some physical factors which are responsible to contribute in soil formation. I think up to this it is okay. And next we will continue in our next class.